Hello learners, welcome to NIOS studio. Today we are going to discuss subject code 508, unit 3, listening or viewing, exploring regional art forms, dance, drama, music, theater and puppetry. So let us start. Performing arts is a subject in which we give education to children by organizing various activities like dance, drama, music, songs, etc. All these activities involve the free expression of feelings, thoughts, emotions, ideas, actions, reactions, attitudes, beliefs, etc. This unit of art education will give an idea about the various disciplines in performing arts and how their implementation will be useful to the learner. Performing arts incorporate music, musical instruments, drama, dance, recitation, narration, literature, etc. Learning objectives. After completion of this unit, you will be able to understand the arena and perspective of performing art, understand our regional art forms, music, dance, theater, puppetry. Relate to performing art activities in day-to-day teaching, explore different art forms and understand their interrelationship. Elements in different performing arts. The basics of all performing arts is listening, viewing, imbibing, imitating, exploring, expressing, performing, etc. First, expression. All living beings have sensory motors which help us to listen, view, smell, touch, and taste. When we actually do the above activities, which are spontaneous to any human being, we give varied expressions. Second, listening. There are varied sounds in our surroundings and environment, like chirping of birds, flowing water, animal sounds, pitter-patter of raindrops, rustling of leaves. The moment one listens, the sound pattern conveys the situation. So, listening is an important and essential exercise. Development of keen observation or viewing improves our capacity of exploration, understanding, and the proper uses of resources available. This correspondingly facilitates performance and presentation. Hence, a teacher should motivate students to develop a sense of viewing every minute detail in their surroundings. This will help not only in planning activities but also gain a better perception of their surroundings, which helps them to utilize local resources that are easily available. First, exploring, listening, imitating, imbibing, relating are the exploration. Through performing art forms, teachers can motivate students to explore by enhancing curiosity. This attitude of exploration helps all gain specific knowledge and innovate. We explore with our perception and understanding. Music. Concept of music. Our environment consists of many different sounds. When we explore more, we experience various types of sound different from each other. If we look around, we hear the sound of a bird chirping, an animal grunting or mewing. Music is an art form whose medium is sound. When we combine the sound in such way that it is smooth, pleasant and in harmony, we call it music. We listen to music in our everyday life from childhood on different occasions, like on childbirth, wedding, festival, at religious places, etc. This music belongs to our region where we find songs touching each part of our life and moods. Vocal music, tune and rhythm are two important elements in music. When we put words in a tune with rhythm, it becomes a song. India has rich legacy of this context in regional music and classical music both. Few examples of regional vocal music are given below categorically. Folk song, Kala Doria Kundena Ladiya Oye. This is from Punjab. Custom songs, Chale Dhan Kate Dhaniya Jaldi Chalna, from Bihar. Bhakti songs, Payo Ji Maine Ram Ratan Dhan Payo, by Mirabai. Integration songs, Mile Sur Mera Tumhara To Sur Bane Hamara. Patriotic songs, Mere Desh Ki Dharti Sona Ugle Ugle Hire Moti, Mere Desh Ki Dharti. Festival songs, Bhaiya Mere Rakhi Ke Bandhan Ko Nibhana. Instrumental music. There are various types of musical instruments available in all the region of the country. Our musical instruments fall under four different categories. The string instruments are known as Taat Vadya, for example, guitar, sitar, sarangi, etc. Second one, the wind instruments are known as Sushir Vadya, for example, flute, shehnai, etc. Number third, the skin instruments are known as Avandha Vadya, for example, dhapli, dholak, etc. The percussions are known as Ghan Vadya. We all see and hear musical instruments in our day-to-day life, like in temples, church, social gatherings, movies, cinema, advertisements, children programs, live concert, etc. Dance. Dance is the expression of body, mind and soul. The coordination of body parts with face expression along with music can be termed dance. India is a country of diverse culture and there are dances in every region which are inherited. The important aspects in dance are body movement, facial expression, music, musical instrument, literature, space management, group and solo coordination, makeup, costumes, etc. Costumes and ornaments of dances are inspired by the atmospheric condition of any area. Regional art forms is performed in groups on religious occasions, marriages, any cultural event, Republic Day parade, local festival of a particular region, movie cinema, tourist places, etc. For example, in Gujarat, Dandiya, or in Punjabi Bhangra, we find thousands of people dancing together to the beat of regional music. Types of dance: solo. Solo dance is performed by an individual. Duet. It is performed by two performers. Generally, it is done to both genders with their individual characteristics or identities at the same time. Group dance. We observe large groups of people dancing together to celebrate occasions. Dhimsa, Devi Puja from Andhra Pradesh, Garba from Gujarat, Bihu from Assam. Types of dances. Number 1. Folk dance. Folk dances involve from the lives of common people and are performed in unison. These dances are performed on the occasion of festivals following rituals and customs. Religious ceremonies, celebration of joys, seasons, etc. Second, classical dance. The dance form that has a developed, creative and solid base work is termed classical. It has a specific style and the skill has to be learned from the gurus. The classical form of dance was performed in temples as well as in royal courts. The dance in temple had a religious objective, whereas in courts it was used purely for entertainment. Now it has moved to the stage for public performance and in classroom for systematic learning. Some of the classical dances are Kathak, Bharatanatyam, Manipuri, Odissi, etc. The adaptation of Western theoretical techniques imbued with elements of Indian classical, folk and tribal dance is a creative form. Uday Shankar was the pioneer in this sort of adaptation, thus laying the roots of modern Indian dance. The art of creativity, improvisation and imagination is the basis for any sort of creative dance. In the preceding years, after Uday Shankar, many dancers like Anand Shankar, Narendra Sharma, etc. have worked in the area of creative dance. Theatre. Concept of theatre. A child is born with natural expression like laughter, smile, cry, excitement, joy, thrill, anger, etc. at birth. At this stage, the child does not have a language but is able to express and also understand others' expression. Theatre is an art form, a platform that provides organization to these expression, thoughts and emotions. The theatre, drama, performances are based on social appreciation, awareness, messages, reduction of social evils. Mythological stories, epics, stories of famous personalities and ritual offering, etc. Role play. Theatre in a child's life begins from the immediate environment through imitation in the form of role play. We experience people playing different roles in our day-to-day life, like washerman, vegetable, vendor, fruit seller, teacher, mates, etc. All these people have a direct relation to the child's life. Children observe people in their surroundings and imitate them. This is role play. It is beneficial for the child to role play as it gives ample opportunity for creativity, outlet of emotions. Voice modulation, self-expression, language development and scope to know the environment in a better way. Storytelling and story act. Storytelling begins from the childhood and plays a very important role in child's life. Usually grandparents used to spend ample time with children. Stories enhance the imagination power in children and gives them opportunity to live it in their own world. The joy of listening to a story and at the same time gaining moral values is a fantastic approach. Storytelling is an art with the combination of expression, gesture, voice modulation, movement, and words. Folk theatre. India presents a colorful assortment of folk culture, best portrayal through the unique art of folk theatre. Local dialect is used in folk theatre. Some of the popular folk theatres are Rasleela, Ramleela, Bhand, Nautanki, Vang, Jatra, etc. Some of the regional theatre forms are given below. Bhand Pathar. This is theatre form belongs to Kashmir and Punjab. Farmers celebrate harvest season and worship God and Goddess. There is a combination of satire, wit and parody. Shikarga is one of the traditional pathar. Krishnattam. Krishnattam is performed every year in Krishna temple of Guruvayur in Kerala. Few more examples of regional theatre forms are given below. Swang of Haryana and Punjab. Nautanki of Uttar Bharat. Rasleela of Uttar Pradesh. Bhavai of Gujarat and Rajasthan. Jatra of Bengal and Odisha. Yakshagana of Karnataka. In urban areas, there is provision of training in theatre as well place to perform. All over the country, there are theatre groups like Nandikar, Prithvi Theatre, Rangayan National School of Drama, etc. who promotes theatre in education, train artists, host mega production for the masses. Puppetry. Puppets are a unique aspects of performing art which can be pedagogy. It helps in spreading social awareness, environmental consciousness, historical incidents, traditional stories like Vikramaditya Battisi, Puppet's Throne, Singhasan Battisi, which helps to teach us morals, etc. Puppets are used to communicate our viewpoints, ideas, and thoughts. All the elements of visual art and craft like colors, harmony, etc. are used in puppetry. Few examples of regional puppetry are given below. Glove puppets of Uttar Pradesh, Odisha, West Bengal and Kerala. String puppetry of Rajasthan, Odisha, Karnataka and Tamil Nadu. Rod puppets of West Bengal and Odisha. Shadow puppetry of Odisha, Kerala, Andhra Pradesh, Karnataka, Maharashtra and Tamil Nadu. Significance of regional art forms, for example, music, dance, theatre and puppetry at elementary level. Regional art forms plays a significant role in child's life at the elementary level. It helps in the holistic development of children. Art forms touch physical, cognitive, emotional, social, spiritual, and language. Participation in activities enhance coordination, cooperation, sharing, and patience, strength of unity, leadership, and ability to initiate and follow. It helps to build positive attitudes towards life. It gives opportunity to solve problems in any situation through exploration. It increases concentration power and attention span. It helps in sharpening the mental abilities. It helps to enhance creativity and imagination. Thank you.